This video is a high-level overview of cooking two breasts with turn event at work. I'm not going to go into a lot of detail about trimming, just the basics. On the bottom here, we just want to get rid of this large chunk of speckle fat, and then shave off any silver skin and visible fat. You can shave none of it off, or all of it, just not however much time you want to spend on it. Spend that much time. Here we're going to cut off what's called the mohawk. If you leave it on there, it's so thin, it's just going to burn and not cook evenly. So just get rid of it. Use the meat for burgers, sausages, tacos, anything you want to use ground beef for. On the thinner flat end, we're going to cut away all the thin spots and just make it more aerodynamic so air will travel around the brisket and cook it more evenly. Any fat that is hard to cut or too thick is going to render down very well, so just cut it away and create a shape that will last better in your flavor. second brisket, we're going to repeat the exact same thing. Trim the silver skin and the fat off the bottom completely, and any fat that's too thick on the top, just remove it. And in there, After seasoning, these breasts need about a 36-hour rest before cooking on Wednesday morning.
Today's 5:30.
Get our pets on the breakfast.
We got our head up temperature and overshot our temperature by quite a bit. Come back down to about 250. Point facing the fire. Take our fat trimmings. Put them in. All right, we'll keep it out. 250, maybe a little bit lower. And check on it here in a couple hours. Check on it at 4 hours. Put some oil on these ends here real fast. That's all we need, put some oil on and see in a couple hours. So here we are, we're 5.5 to 6 hours in right now. Still waiting on that back to get softer. I did swap the two around, so the one that's in the back pulled it to the front. I think I'm gonna turn these guys around to try to get the air to come onto the fat one. Poke this. Got a gusher right here. I think we're getting there. Turning this around with the right call, so I can track it rendered out. I'll bring it back once we're ready to wrap.
When inserting a probe into them, it was time to lower the temp a bit inside and hold them overnight. So both were put into a double lined vac seal bag and left in 165 degree water bath. One tip is to leave a temperature probe in the water and have it alert you if your water temp gets below 160 degrees, if your sous vide machine fails or your power goes out. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like and subscribe button. It really helps me out. If you'd like to see a more detailed video on how to trim and cook a brisket, please let me know in the comment section below.